Happy Fabulous Friday. Woo! Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. She's a world-renowned speaker, Bible teacher, best-selling author, and actress. And with highly successful faith-based films like War Room to her credit, she passionately spreads messages of hope and love to the masses.
With a strong faith in God as her fuel, she's back on the big screen in a new movie called Overcomer. Let's take a look.
At this point, I don't think I could save football, but I do think I have a solution for cross country.
Who? No.
I believe you could do it.
Olivia, I'm not a cross country coach. I don't even like running. Amy bought me a treadmill 3 years ago. I never use it.
I don't want to have to cancel another program.
Wow.
Please welcome back to the circle, Priscilla Shirer.
Yes. Clap it up, everybody. Woo! There we go. Hello,
hello,
beautiful. Watch your step, watch your step.
Be careful.
How you doing, girl?
Well, my heart.
Hey, yes. Welcome back.
Come on, have a seat, my love.
Good
yes,
to see you guys.
Good to see you as
yes.
well.
Thanks for having me back.
Absolutely. So, you know, of course, we love your Instagram page, and we went down to your page, and
uh-oh.
You've been on lots of red carpets lately. And here's a quote that you said: I don't get to do this sort of thing often, so indulge me while I enjoy the fact that I get to play dress up twice
that's
this
right.
week. So that's a beautiful
right.
thing. How are you balancing everything? Movies, motherhood, and what's your self-care look like?
Oh, thanks for asking that. You know what? We prioritize. So me and Jerry, my husband of 20 years, we're always looking at our year and going, okay, what is most important? How can we best honor God with the year that is ahead?
Mm-hmm.
So that means prioritizing each other and our three sons.
Yes.
And I mean, we literally write it down on the calendar, the stuff that's important in our life and in our son's life, and then we filter everything else around that.
Okay.
So that means we say no all
a lot.
We say no all the time.
Yes.
But every no is a simultaneous yes.
yes.
Mm-hmm. And so I don't feel guilty about no. I feel okay.
Yes.
I feel free to say no.
No, yes.
But that means I get to be at my son's football game,
mm-hmm.
or I get to be home making dinner for my family.
That's obedience.
Know? Yeah. Yeah. And it matters. Those things matter. You know,
mm-hmm.
family
yes.
matters. So
speaking of that, when you are presented with acting roles, what things must line up with that script in your life
yeah.
for you to say yes to it?
Well, my purpose is ministry. That's mm-hmm. why I know the Lord has me here,
mm-hmm.
ministry. And so if a script isn't focused on that goal, then it's not for me.
Mm-hmm.
Because there are many incredible actresses. I mean, like actual for real actresses who are trained and who can do, you know, film roles incredibly well. But I know to stay in alignment with what God has called me to do, because we only have so much time.
Yes.
We only have so many resources that we can lend toward, you know, in our lifetime that we can lend toward the things that are in front of us to do. And so if there's a project that's going to glorify God, I mean,
mm-hmm.
I'm not talking about a sugar-coated water down.
Yeah.
I'm talking about one that says Jesus Christ is still Lord.
Yes.
Then I know that that's
right
a film that
yes.
I might be able to contribute
yes.
to. And I'm
yes.
grateful that God keeps including me in these projects.
Yeah.
I'm grateful, yeah.
That's awesome.
You just released a book. Let me get it right. It's called Radiant,
yes.
His Light, Your Life.
Yes.
And can you speak to the condition of young ladies?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And so it is a book that is geared toward young women.
Mm-hmm.
And the goal is to remind them that you are not your behavior.
Mm.
You are not your struggle. You are not your worst mistake. You are not your past. You're not what has been done to you. Those things might be what you have experienced.
Right.
But that's not who you are.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I think the struggle is that we are having to help them to make a disparity. Us too, not just younger women.
Right.
All of us have to realize there is a difference between where you've been and what you've done and what has happened to you and who you are.
Yes.
Your significance is not rooted in those things.
Mm-hmm.
Your significance and value has already been established by God.
Mm-hmm.
You are who your Father says you are,
right.
no matter what has happened to
yes.
you, and your value is there.
Absolutely. Mm. We've got more with this woman of God, Priscilla
mm-hmm.
Shirer, and her Overcomer co-star, Erin Wright
Yay.
Thompson, when we return.
She's amazing.
Right. Yes, hi, Erin. Look at her. Hey, everybody, we are back with actress and prayer warrior Priscilla Shirer, and she's joined by the shining star of the new movie Overcomer, Miss Erin Wright Thompson.
Yes.
Yay, the beautiful Erin Wright Thompson. Oh my
you.
Gosh, you're just as cute as pie. So let me ask you this, Erin. Is this your first movie?
Yes, it is.
Oh my gosh, that's wonderful. So what did you enjoy most about working on this film?
I think I loved the acting part, but I also got to watch people do their job. So even days I didn't have to work, I would go with the hair person and watch them do it, or I would go with the wardrobe, or one day I actually got to be a production assistant, which was so fun. That was the best part.
Really?
Yes.
You know, a lot of PAs won't say that. So that's good that you want to have experience in all facets. Where do you see yourself going in this film industry?
I definitely think I want to be a director, and I want to just be an inspiration to kids to let them know that they can do anything that they put their minds to.
Yes.
And I just want them to know, even if you come from a small town, you can do it, because I come from a very small town. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't matter what people say about you, you got it.
You got it. What's her strongest asset?
You know what? I think it's her humility, that there is a tenderness and a sweetness to her, and she hasn't lost that at all. There are people that are starting to pay her a lot of attention, and she's still errant, still sweet, and still humble. And that right there is going to carry you a lot.
Exactly. Stay that way. Yes. Please, please.
Yeah. Okay. Well, of all the themes that this movie showcases, which one sticks or resonates the most with you? We'll start with you, Priscilla.
Okay. Well, the overarching theme of the film is identity, and so I know that you could speak to that a lot, but one of the sort of undercurrent themes there is mentoring, I believe, because that's the relationship we get to have in the film, that there is a woman that's walked the road just a little bit longer that pays attention to a younger girl and that says, listen, I hear what you're saying, but I'm going to read in between the lines of what you're saying and just kind of pick a little bit till I can get to what's really going on in your heart.
Yes.
The fact that there was a woman that would spend time with a younger woman.
Yeah.
Man, I'm hoping that folks walk away from the film and realize the importance of mentoring and relationship.
Yes.
That's critical in all of our lives.
Absolutely, absolutely. What about you?
I'd say definitely the key theme is identity, like she said, but I've always struggled with trying to be like everybody else. And even in elementary school, I just never had a lot of friends, so I would try to conform to fit into their box.
Yeah.
But now I know that God loves me, and that's the greatest love I can ever have, so I don't have to change for anybody else.
Yes.
That's so good that she knows that early. To experience that, especially at such a young age.
Absolutely.
So important. Mm-hmm. You just don't know how important that is.
That revelation will change your life.
Yes.
Yes.
Like, for real.
Yeah, for real. Yes. And Erin, you're a young lady of so many wonderful talents, but what do you love the most about being involved in the arts?
What I love the most is just being able to express myself in a different way. Some people use a therapist. I kind of use like dance as my therapy or acting as my therapy, and it just really helps me, and it challenges me to be a different person sometimes with acting.
Good. Well, we're so happy that you've come down to the Circle.
Thank you. We wish you much success.
Yes. Please make sure you check out Erin and Priscilla in the new movie Overcomer, which hits theaters August 23rd. If you're sticking around for the full Circle, Miss Priscilla is going to join us at the table. So we can get a little deeper.
You understand? All right. And don't forget, the conversation always continues at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms. Stay with us.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. As promised, Priscilla Shirer is back with us at the table, and wanted to do something special, but we'll get to that in just a moment. You know, earlier in our daily feed, I talked to Quad, of course, and Trina about feeling hopeless with all the tragedies that are going on in this world. Can you speak to that? And do you think we'll come out on top? Will love win? You know, I know that God is in the midst. But when it's so much is going on, it feels like, to a lot of people, believers and non-believers, where is God?
You know, it's easy for us to blame God when bad things happen. It's quick for us to point a finger and say, where are you, God? But the reality is, the only reason why there is ever any good, the only reason why there is ever any sense of peace or happiness or joy that dots through our lives, is because God is good.
Right.
Because listen, if he stays his hand, if he holds back the restraint that he has against evil in this world, then we would really see what trouble there would be with no God. God is present, he is there, he will never leave us nor forsake us. But can I tell you, this is when faith really matters. I'm not talking about just kind of casually going to church. I'm talking about where you actually have a thing going on with the Lord. If you don't, then you're right, hopelessness will be pervasive in your life. It'll overwhelm you. But that's what being an overcomer is all about.
All right,
it means you have something to overcome, and because of your relationship with the Lord, you are able to do it. It doesn't take you under. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, yes.
It's on you. The burden's on you. See it, you feel it. Your heart hurts when you see the stuff that's been happening all across the world. Your heart hurts, but you're not overwhelmed. You understand, this is not my home.
Right.
I'm on my way somewhere. I'm passing through. and I'm gonna do what God has called me to do while I'm here. I'm gonna stay afloat with the hope and the joy and the peace that's internal, mm-hmm. so that when everything else externally is going haywire, I don't have to go haywire. Mm-hmm. Yeah. As for me and my house, we can have peace even mm-hmm. when the world does not. Mm-hmm. That's what faith means.
All right, because we're going to get into these devotions, okay? Okay, in day 38 of your Awaken Daily devotional, because I'm going to get this right, you talk about the beauty and contentment. And you say, I quote, contentment comes from valuing what you've been given, not venting over what's been withheld. Mm. So how do we master the balance of appreciating what we have with our ambition and for what we don't... but we just don't know what's going on for ourselves.
Like, you know what's going on? The key is to contentment? It's gratitude. Yeah. Mm, that's baby, the key. The key is looking around you and going, you know what? I still desire this. I still mm-hmm. got goals. I still want to achieve this. I don't have the house that I'd like to live in. I don't have the career success maybe that I'd like to
have.
But
what I do have.
But what do I have?
Right. Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you, you start looking around you and you just recognize, oh my goodness, God has been so good. My health, I got my health. Mm-hmm. My kids are all right. Mm-hmm. I got a roof over mm-hmm. my head. Mm-hmm. Do you know that even if you are poor in this country, you are still rich in comparison to people that are in other parts of the world.
Right.
But oftentimes, because we're just so busy comparing ourselves with each other, that we can't even look around anymore and say, you know what? I got some water in this cup right now.
Right, right.
God has been good to me. Mm-hmm. Gratitude, I mean, I know it kind of sounds cliche, it for real is. I have a list. Like, I literally will write 1 through 10 in the mornings and just I write down what I'm praying for. But I start by writing down 10 things today that I'm starting my day with. Lord, thank you for these 10 things right here. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Come on, grace and mercy. Grace and mercy, I just got to tell you about it. So let's talk a little bit about day 49, okay? Day 49 of your devotional is called One Thing at a Time, okay? Because we know sometimes we kind of get off track a little bit. We think about everything as a cohesive whole instead of one thing at a time. Okay, you said, and this is your quote, you said, focusing on one thing can lead to the untangling of everything. Mm-hmm. My God. Okay, so how do we best pinpoint when we are overextending ourselves and we are doing too much mentally and then and our schedule is going haywire?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How do we pinpoint that?
Well, I would say to check the gauges that matter in your life. Check the relationships that matter most to you. Are they strained? Are they stressed? Is there tension consistently in them? Check yourself. Check your own peace of mind, stability of emotions. Are you strained? Are you stressed? Is your health intact? When you checked some of those primary gauges in your life, mm-hmm. they are the main detectors to let you know if everything is out of balance and out of whack. Once you start seeing that those priorities are strained, then you got to make the brave choice to begin to carve out time, as we talked about earlier. Carve out the courage to say no.
Yeah.
That I gotta start declining and saying mm-hmm. no and not feeling guilty about mm-hmm. it. Because every no is a simultaneous yes. Mm-hmm. It means I get to say yes to my family, yes to my spouse, yes to myself. Mm-hmm. And it's okay to have some time on your calendar that says me.
Right.
I like
that says me.
Yeah. You know, you minister a lot in your books and talk about identity, like who we are in the world, how we show up to others and how we show up to ourselves, and recognizing the many talents that we have. But how do you differentiate, or how did you differentiate using all of the talents that God has given you at the proper time in your life?
Okay, because timing is everything, mm-hmm. right? I think patience is the key to that, and obviously I can say that in hindsight, because when you're in it, when you're 21 and want everything right now,
right?
Mm-hmm. You don't really exercise it. But if I could go back and tell my 20-year-old self something, it would be, girl, just slow down and enjoy this season that you're in right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Most of the time, for me, I didn't appreciate the beauty of the season I was in mm-hmm. until I was out of it.
Yes.
And then I looked back on it and went, golly.
How do you think your life would be different had you appreciated it in the moment? Mm-hmm. How do you think it would be different?
There would have been relationships I took more seriously. There would have been lessons that I didn't just learn real quick and move on. I would have absorbed them and incorporated to my life. I would have recognized that the character that was being built was just as critical, if not more, than the skill that I was accumulating at the time. And so I would have used all of that and recognized all of this is a stair step that is going to be required for me to do well in the next season.
Come on now.
So I would have just milked it more. I would have sat in it more. Mm-hmm. I would have sat with the people mm-hmm. more. I would have gleaned mm-hmm. more. I would have listened more. I would have stopped talking so much mm-hmm. and would have just had open hands and an open heart to receive, because that was the foundation that would be necessary for yes. places I didn't even know God was going to take me.
Mm-hmm. Come on, yeah. I hope you receive that good word from yes. Priscilla Shirer. We thank you so much for being the light.
Thank you.
We thank you so much for being here today. And the books that she's mentioned, Radiant, Awaken, and Gideon, you can find them wherever fine books are sold. And don't forget to check out Priscilla's new film, Overcomer, which opens in theaters August 23rd. And there's Erin! Yes. Thank you so much, Priscilla Shirer!
Thank y'all. Love you guys.
Yes!